I'd like to talk about the use of the VLOOKUP function in this video tutorial. To start, I'll look at these two tables that are in the upper left-hand portion of this worksheet. This first block of data here represents people's income for a given year, -1,000, 30,000, 29,000, 98,000, 104,000. These could be in any order, really. And what we want to do is look up their tax rate that's going to be available in another table of data or range of data based on these values. The table or the range that we will be looking in is this table right here, and it shows for a given income what the tax rate would be. And something to be aware of is that if something's in between one of those values, it will, as it goes to do its lookup, it will choose the value that is lower than the next highest bracket. So for example, if I were to look up 29,000 in this table, it would say, well, that's almost 30,000, but it's not, so I will go with the next lowest category, which evaluates to 0.3. So there are going to be four important arguments in this function, so I'll type in equals V lookup. The first thing that it asks for is what is the value in this row that I'm going to be using to look to match against in another table. And typically when we're doing this, or quite commonly, it's going to be the value just to the left. So in this case, I want to look for the value in C8, which is -1,000, within, and then it says, you know, it's asking me, where am I going to look for this value? Now in this particular case, this block of data has already been given a named range, or it is a named range called a lookup. So if I highlight this, I could instead do a fixed range reference of C16 to D19 with the dollar signs in front of them, but this named range works just as well. So you can see it's highlighted in red what the lookup area is. Now it's saying, now the next question is, which column number do I want to look in? So assuming, well, I should mention one other thing, that it assumes that when you're looking for values in this table, that the thing that you're trying to match against is going to be found in the first column. So it always has to be arranged that way. All right. In our case, we're looking for the tax rate, which is going to be found in the second column, so I'll put the number 2. And then the next argument is optional, and in a case like this where we do not have exact matches, but we are trying to match things within a certain interval, then using this approximate match is the way to do it. And I should note that it only works as long as these values that you're matching against are in ascending order. If they're not in ascending order, it'll mess it up. So it goes to do a lookup and it says not available, or something to that effect, whatever NA means, essentially not found, there's no match. So that one's a little weird. The reason is there's nothing below 0 for it to match against. So it knows that this value is less than 0, but there's nothing there. If the value had been 9,000, then it would know to look for less than, you know, 10,000, and it would have matched against 0.15. All right, if I drop this down a little bit and go to the next one, it says it's matching against C9, so it's look up C9 in the lookup table and look in column 2. Oops. And what it comes out with is 0.34. So there was actually an exact match for that, and it returned that. If I go down to the next one, it gives me 0.3. Even though that's almost 30,000, it's not quite there, and so it goes to the next lowest value. So I'll repeat that, and I get what values that I would expect. For example, for 104,000, that's greater than this value, so it assigns this value to it. Now, if I do the same thing as before using the same function, I want to look for this value in the lookup table, and I want to match against number 2. And this time I'm going to click on false, which is exact match. Personally, I don't try to remember whether I'm supposed to use true or false as my last argument. Personally, I like to remember instead, am I trying to do an exact match in the table or an approximate match within some interval? If I try and do an exact match, if you do just eyeball this, you'll note that the only thing that has an exact match in this table down here is 30,000. The rest of these are in between these other values, and so you would expect then that I'm going to get NAs in all except for one case, which is in fact what happens. So this was done to simply to demonstrate the use of using VLOOKUP with true as the last argument in the function and false with the last argument in the function. Now, as it relates to analytics, a common thing that comes up is you will have two very different spreadsheets and you'll want to combine them. Maybe there will be well, there'll be maybe you're trying to build one really big worksheet with columns that has many variables of interest that you're going to be putting into some statistics software for analysis. And in order to do that, you're pulling in a whole bunch of other worksheets that would likely have in them something like an ID and some value that you're interested in. So even though you can do this interval matching true option, I find that false is the more interesting and useful option for analytics in most cases, because you're going to be trying to construct data sheets that you can or that you'll convert into CSV files that you will import into statistics software. So as a somewhat partial example of this, I have another table here. In this case, I'm going to be doing the false match. So what I want to do here is look up B2211 in this list of prices and or product numbers and table and prices. So if I do equals VLOOKUP and I want to look up this value in the range, which happens to be called lookup 2, I want to look in the second column, and this time I will do false for an exact match, and it returns 5.2. And I can repeat that, and it gets all the right lookups. To make it format a little better, I'll make it a dollar currency format. So, and just to give an example of how this would be useful for analytics, in the exercise that I have available, here is a listing. Here's an incomplete worksheet that I want to try and populate a bunch of other columns based on information that's in other sheets where only the IDs are listed. So in this case, I have here's the team ID and the name, and I might want to go over into a different worksheet to pull out the division that matches that particular ID, and I might want to go into a different worksheet to find out the scores. So this type of problem where a bunch of different features related to a given ID value are found in other worksheets.